We did quite a lot of research about the local area, and we found a lot of stuff on the council website about threatened and endangered species, and that aroused our curiosity because we've worked with endangered species before and quite recently. And simultaneously, we were returning to our old home in the Burrarang Valley where the fires had been quite terrible, and we found this tree that had been amongst a grove of burning native cypress trees, but this one had been pushed over by the fire crews, so it was completely intact from root to tip. It's an Australian native cypress called Colitris muelleri. These relatives of the species were used a lot for construction, floorboards and wool sheds out west, and it's termite resistant, it's really resilient. Our previous big project together was called Mirityana, Out in the Sunlight, and that's about a little dragon lizard. So we'd done quite a bit of thinking about what dragons mean in various cultures around the world.
When we thought about doing a dragon and thinking about how the dragon's related to the environment and culture and things, and I was thinking, what would this dragon sound like? So my immediate thought was drones for some reason, as they have this sort of slightly ominous undertone, that they can be quite beautiful, they can be quite threatening, they can be all sorts of things.
They're always about a kind of desire for a more symbiotic relationship with the rest of nature, I think, because they can be very threatening and dangerous if they're not treated with respect, and they very often guard water holes. So they control drought. Sometimes their body might lie across a river and block the flow of water. Sometimes they can be in the heavens controlling the thunderbolts and the rain. Fearsome things if they're not treated right. So it seemed like a really powerful metaphor for where we're at the moment, where we're facing these really critical tipping points with our climate and species loss. I love that kind of marriage of wood and steel. I love the fact that it's got a quite a 19th century colonial kind of feel, actually. So that sort of refers to, you know, a period when things really started to get critical. But there's also this kind of possibility of hope. I'm hoping that we move forward to a more symbiotic relationship with the rest of life on Earth and pay respect to the dragon or the serpent.